Discuphytes. Discuphytes were the first multicellular clade to evolve over Reccembra. They are obligate phototrophs, meaning that they require the sun's light to function. In their case, to break down the nutrients they absorb into usable components. A discophyte's life begins when two gene packets of the opposite sex encounter each other and mix into a single individual. This new life form, consisting of around a dozen cells, begins absorbing nutrients found in the water around it and growing. During the entirety of the discophyte's life, its new cells are always created from the original gene packet cells, meaning that it grows from its center, and even if the edges of the organism are damaged, they can always be replaced as it grows. At this point in history, discophyte anatomy is pretty simple. Making up the skin of the organisms are cells covered in flagella, whose primary function is to absorb components floating in the water around them. Right below these collector cells is another class of cell, in charge of breaking down the absorbed components using the sun's energy. Depending on the species, there can be 2 to 10 layers of the cells surrounding the initial gene packets, whose function is to take the broken down nutrients and make new cells out of them. Reproduction occurs cyclically. How long this cycle is mostly depends on the species complexity, but can also be altered by how many resources are in the discophyte's vicinity. The smallest species have cycles which repeat multiple times a day, while the biggest species only reproduce once every few weeks. The cycle starts when the plant starts gathering nutrients. Once it has enough, it starts duplicating in central gene packets, which are later broken up into two pieces and detached from the mother plant. It should be noted that no species starts reproducing before it has grown large enough to constantly have enough energy and nutrients to make new gene packets. There are multiple clades of discophytes so far. One of them is the bull grass. Bull grasses are one of the first discophyte lineages to evolve. Indeed, they evolved so early that they don't even have the characteristic disc shape of the clade. They have this name because of the way they look when viewed from the ocean surface, resembling a sheet of recently mowed grass floating in the ocean. Because of their small size, only 1 to 5 millimeters, they are easily dragged around by ocean currents, and so have become multicellular phytoplankton. But this doesn't hinder their development, as their small size means they don't need much sunlight to break up the nutrients required for reproduction, and so they still survive as the most numerous discophytes of the protocene. Another adaptation for their planktonic lifestyle is an alternating cycle, where they only gather nutrients while in the shade of bigger plants, and only break them up while in the sunlight. Next up is stickweed. Stickweeds are another small group of species, only reaching around 6 millimeters, related to the bull grasses. Like the bull grasses, they are in disc shape, instead having an oblong shape similar to that of a rugby ball. Their name comes from their ability to cling to other discophytes using specialized roots covered in a sticky substance. This is a safe way to ensure they don't get pushed into darkness while still remaining fully underwater, unlike some of their larger relatives. Furballs. Furballs are another oblong-shaped discophyte. Like their stickweed relatives, they have evolved their external flagella into root-like structures. However, instead of using them to anchor themselves, furballs use them to maximize nutrient absorption, giving them their names and look, with hairs sprouting in every direction. Bristle discs. Bristle discs were one of the first actually disc-shaped discophytes to evolve. They are still quite small, only reaching 8 millimeters, but they are big enough to float above the bull grass carpet and get the most sunlight as possible. Like all disc-shaped discophytes, they possess a ring of roots, actually extended flagella made of multiple cells, running around their outer edge. As they get older and grow larger, the amount of roots also increases. However, this doesn't make them more effective, as they also have to supply materials to a bigger amount of cells. It is normal in this clade for collector cells to have a pair or more flagella instead of the ancestral singular flagellum. Hairbacks. These larger, around 1 cm, more energy-expensive discophytes have found a novel way to acquire more nutrients easily. Instead of only having a ring of roots, they are completely covered in a small coat of hair, much like the furballs. Each strand of this hair is made up of multiple interlacing flagella, each with a delicate branching structure similar to a feather to maximize its surface area. This is as effective as a discophyte without multicellular roots could get, and so the hairbacks are one of the most widespread clades and can be found all across Reccembran oceans. Buckwheat. Buckwheat is the ancestor of all discophytes with multicellular roots. Instead of using the collector cells' flagella as roots, the collector cells themselves are used to create fine branching structures which hang at the edges of the plant. While there are some small buckwheat species which hang onto other discophytes, most are large and free-floating, reaching up to 2 cm, and only use their roots for nutrient acquisition. Jelly plants. Jelly plants are by far the largest discophytes in the protocene, with the smallest species being around 3 cm long, and the biggest being larger than 10 in diameter, and almost twice that in length. Their discs stick up above the water, aided by surface tension and many small hairs on their underside, to stay afloat. Their long branching roots are home for many other discophytes, such as stickweed and some bugweed species, even some filter-fed exoanimals, which will be discussed later. They have three types of roots, the long-hanging ones they use to acquire nutrients, another ring further up, which helps to keep them upright, and the thousands of hairs on the disc's underside, which are also modified roots. The largest of jelly plants can take months to reproduce only once, but once fully grown, their parts will get immortal, repairing easily from wounds that would be lethal to most discophytes, and living for over 2 Earth years. Since the top of their discs, where the clone's gene packets are usually grown, sticks above the water, jelly plants have evolved to grow their gene packets downwards instead, making them the only disc-shaped discophytes to do so. Speaking of gene packets, while most of them are nothing but specks to the human eye, jelly plants' unsplit gene packets can be as large as a pea, making it quite difficult for reproduction to be successful. This is why most jelly plants grow in colonies, and some species have even adapted the tips of their nutrient-absorbing roots to capture and retain gene packets which float by, keeping them from sinking and giving them more chances to become a new plant.